In the previous video, we discussed how we can take the histogram of images using the pixel intensity values. On the same lines, we can also take the histogram of images using the features. And how do you extract the features? You can use either hog or SIFT to extract the features. That is, you first divide the image into grid, let's say 20 by 20 or 30 by 30 grid. And in each block, you extract the hog or SIFT features. Now let's say for this image, these are the features that you managed to extract, plus circles and triangles. You repeat the same step even for this image. Here, you are able to extract stars, lightnings, and blasts. Okay, these are the features that you managed to extract. Once you have extracted the features, you need to create the codebook. This is the same technique that we used to create the histogram bins. So in my codebook, I have 6 different features. Triangle, circle, plus the blast symbol, star, and the lightning. So this is the association that I have created. And this forms my codebook. Once you have the codebook, what you can do is, you can just draw the histograms. Here, quite simply, what I can do is, I can just count the number of circles in this image, and the number of triangles, and the number of plus symbols. So you will have around 10 triangles, 6 plus symbols, and 8 circles. Similarly, from this image, I can create this histogram. Now let's see how we can actually create this codebook. Please note that though in this image, most of the plus symbols look similar to each other, in reality, they will all be slightly different from each other. To identify the features, what you can do is, you can use a k-means clustering. Once you do the clustering, all the features that are very similar to each other will fall into the same group. I'll have the plus symbols in one group, the circles in one group, triangles, stars, lightning, and the blast, all of these features in their own groups, separate groups. This is how I'll be able to create the codebook. A practical example of this would be, I can take the features near the handlebar of different bikes, okay? And for all those images, the histogram, the hog or SIFT feature will look like this. For second set of images, I can take the features related to the mirror part of the vehicle, okay? So this is also mirror, this is one mirror, here there is another mirror. So for all these mirrors, I can generate the hog or SIFT feature. And they all might look like this. So when I do the clustering, all these 3 handlebars might fall into one single group like this, and all the 3 mirror images might fall into another group like this. So this is how I'll be able to cluster the features of different images. And once I do the clustering, I can just create the codebook. And once I have the codebook, I can just easily draw the histogram. It's not always necessary that codebooks related to some other image are not present in the first one. For example, if you take this image, you can mostly see the person, but some features related to the bicycle are also seen. And similarly, in the second image, you can mostly see the bicycle, but you can also see some features related to the person, the hands, legs, etc. So as an analogy, you can look at this image where mostly you will have triangles, circles, and plus symbols, but also you'll have some features related to some other image. So practically, when you draw the histograms, this is how it might look. You will have the features from different images, but usually one set of these features will be dominating. On the same lines, similar to this image here, this example here, when I draw the histogram, I'll mostly have features related to the second image. That is, I'll have mostly the star symbols, the blast, and lightning symbols. Apart from that, I'll have very few circles, plus, and triangle symbols. So usually, star, lightning, and blast symbols will dominate this histogram. So what is the use of this technique, bag of visual words? Using this technique, just by looking at the histogram, I can determine what kind of image it is. In this first histogram, I can take a look at it and say, okay, it might be a histogram of a person. And in the second example, I can look at it and say, this might be a histogram of a bicycle. That is, I'll see what are the codebooks that are mostly dominating in this histogram, and I'll conclude that it might be pertaining to the related object. Some more examples of bag of visual words. In these 3 images, you have different textures, so you can combine all the features in these 3 images to form this codebook. And for the first image, when you plot the histogram, it might look like this. And this is the histogram for the second and third images. So by looking at which of these codebooks are dominating in each of these histograms, I can decide or conclude what kind of image or what kind of pattern it is. On the same lines, you can even create the bag of words histogram representation for faces. That is, you can collect many images of faces and then you can create the codebooks for human faces. For some more examples representing the feature set for aeroplane landing gear and so on. So these are just some examples for the features that you can extract. Once you can extract the features, you can cluster them using k-means clustering, and from this cluster you can create the codebooks, and using the codebooks you now draw the histograms, and by looking at the histograms you can conclude what kind of image it is. So that's the main advantage of the bag of visual words representation.